Today the Coptics are about 10%, 20% of the population, and they're being persecuted. Nigeria has a place in the heart of God, and I'll conclude with this. Nigeria is key to God's end time plan for the world. Nigeria is meant to be united and is meant to be in the hands of those that believe in the one true God. When that happens, the final revival before the coming of Messiah will be orchestrated and engineered from the nation of Nigeria. That is why it is so important for those that do not believe in our God to take control of everything. They're being inspired by a force, a dark force. But at the same time, we are being inspired by the force of God and the forces of light. That God's plan must stand. And what is that plan? A united country. A country whose foundation is love, peaceful, and mutual respect for one another, regardless of your faith. A country that we all move together, first and foremost as Nigerians, before anything else. Not a country where, because you're a middle belter, you are told you are nothing. Or a southerner, you're told you are nothing. Or where, in a country, not a country where, if you're a Christian, you're told you don't have a voice. You don't mean anything. Not a country where some will be master and others will be servants. Some will be slaves and others will be slave owners. Some will be born to rule, others will be born to be ruled. That was not God's plan. You cannot hide a light under a bush. You cannot cloak the light of God with the darkness of another force. We must rise, and we will rise. Let me end by saying this. I have a friend, I won't mention his name. He's a governor now, good friend of mine. And a few years ago, he said something to me. I've said this on various occasions, I've told my friends. He said to me that they intend to get Jonathan out of power. This was in 2014 or thereabouts. I said, how? He said, the way we're going to do it is that we'll mobilize the whole of the Northwest, who are Muslims. We'll mobilize the Middle Belt Muslims. We'll mobilize the Muslims of the Southwest, and we'll get him out. And I said, what about the rest of the country? He said, and he was right, that if you look at the number of registered voters, Southeast and South-South put together do not come anywhere near the number of registered voters in the Northwest. I was shocked, but he was right, because I went to confirm. He said, so it's just a question of using Islam to take power and giving it to Buhari. And I asked him a question. I said, how will the Christians of the Middle Belt feel if you come up with such an agenda? He said, the Christians of the North, and he refused to. I said, Middle Belt, he said, no, North. He said, we don't recognize Middle Belt. He said, the Christians of the North are nothing. I will repeat this. He's alive, but he's a governor today. I just wrote, there's no need for me to mention his name. He said, the Christians of the North are nothing. Okay, good friend of mine, we were in government together. I'll go that far. I should be able to work it out. Now, it didn't stop there. 2 weeks later, I went to see an elder statesman. He invited me for lunch. My father was the chairman of his wedding many years ago. Again, I won't mention his name. I won't say, though, that he once came from Plateau State, and he's now from Nasarawa State. Elder statesman. Very, very short man. Just like the other one, very short. And lovely man, I've known him, you know, throughout my youth. I haven't seen him for many. He invited me to lunch. And luckily for me, I went with a good friend of mine, Yusuf Tuka, who was in the Federal House at the time. He's now our ambassador in Germany. I went with Yusuf and about 10 other members of the Federal House. We all went together. So they will, you know, can bear witness to what I'm about to tell you. And we started talking about the country. And this elder statesman, an elderly man, an elder statesman, not a young person, we're having lunch, and he said, we started talking about the country, and he said, I said, what does he think will happen? Who does he say? We're with Buhari. I said, good. I said, but why, sir? Why are you with Buhari? That look at what has happened in the past, look at what he might do. You know, how come? And in any case, he did his analysis. I said, okay, how do you feel? How would the Middle Belt Christians feel about this? How would they feel? You know what he said to me? The Holy Spirit is my witness. He's here. If I'm lying, may God judge me. He said to me, Femi, the Christians of the North are nothing. The same words that my friend used. And I realized something. And the minute he said, I turned around to Yusuf in front, I said, Yusuf, you see what I tell you, that the only answer to the problems of this country is for us to have a sovereign national conference and go back to the beginning. I said, sir, how could you possibly say that? He said, I'm from Nasarawa. We used to be Plateau State. I know the North. I'm telling you, they are nothing. I find it hard to sit somewhere and anybody will tell me that my people, because you see, the blood of Jesus binds us. It doesn't matter whether you're from the North or South or whatever. You call yourself a Christian, you're really a Christian, it binds us. I said, these are my brothers and sisters. And you say they're nothing. Thank you very much, sir. I finished my meal and I left. I never went back. They called me a few times. I have never been, and I will never, never, very bad. I will never, never sit in that man again. Never. That is what we are facing.